this is Alex, Alex's Paw Squad. I have Diva here with me today. She is a Pumi, a P-U-M-I. You don't see Pumis very often. She's the only one that I've seen in 7 years of grooming. So they're definitely more of a rare breed, but she's super cute. So I already gave her a bath, blow dry, did her nails, pads, and shaved her sanitary area. Now I'm taking a two guard, and I'm gonna take all this length off her. I see her about every 6 weeks. So Pumis have very specific grooming styles as far as their face goes mostly. So I'll go over that more when we get there. And then also at the end of her grooming, we actually wet her back down. So do the bath, blow dry, groom her, make her look all pretty. And then we're gonna take our hose and we're gonna kind of mist her all over and wet her back down. And what that does is it gives her that curly Pumi coat. So she still looks like a Pumi, and when she dries, she'll still be groomed, but she has all of her little curls back. Because when we dry her with the Velocity dryer, most of all those curls are gonna kind of come out and be dried straight. So. Definitely have a groomer first. I'm going to take this card all over. Just like a typical grooming for this body. A lot of them get hand scissors, but that takes hours of work. And especially since we're wetting her down, you're not going to be able to tell that she was hand scissored or not either way. She's very well behaved. She had a groomer in California that table trained her very, very well. So she knows the process. She knows everything what to do. Alright. Start taking her down. I'm gonna go ahead and do the rest of her body. And then we will go ahead and use our shears and trim up her feet. Alright, so now I'm taking my curved shears. Go ahead and trim up all her feet. I do like to leave them rounded because she's got that fluffier look. Even once we wet her down and she has those curls, she's still gonna have a fluffier look to her. So I want to give them a nice rounded look. We don't want to take them too crazy short.
Brushing
their actual ear. So, I'll pull the ear forward. Lift that up, get stick up and look more separate. now. And one thing, guys, that makes a huge difference in grooms is shaving right their lips right here. A lot of dogs won't like it, but if you are able to do it, it makes a big difference just in the way they look. It looks a lot more clean. It's like one of those things that's like, wow, and they look really good and you can't pinpoint it, but it's really, really makes a difference. Look how pretty that face is. So that's what a Pumi face should look like. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask. Now, I did use an O-guard on the face, but that might change based off of, you know, what you're using on the body or what the owner wants. But that is how you do the style of the face. So I'm going to clean everything up, and then we can wet her down in just a minute.
All right, guys. So now I have her in the tub, and we put this on misting mode. So we're going to go ahead and mist her down really quick. Then I'm going to rub my hands. See how she's not soaking wet, but she's damp. And then that way, when she goes home, she will dry and be curly. It is a little cold outside, but Mom will let her in right away and keep her warm. So we're gonna go ahead and do that to the rest of her body, and then she'll be ready to go home. And that's how you groom a Pumi. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.